The title of my poem is A Journey of a Thousand Miles. It starts with one step, a step that we began 4 days ago. On the morning that we met, all 28 of us, going into a whole new world full of promise. We began with the games, two games that showed to us that equality and non-discrimination must be the cornerstones of our work. We started with formal equality, that we are all born equal, but we did not finish the journey together as we started. And in there, we knew that we will often require specific measures to address the inequalities, that we will need accessibility, and that sometimes we may require reasonable accommodation. Do you recall how we were both introduced to new concepts on that first day? We encountered the CRPD. Well, some of us for the very first time, others not. We encountered the humanitarian principles, the humanitarian program cycle, and legal frameworks. Do you remember some of them? We started as two groups, but we were brought together. We started to see the similarities, that we are not so different after all, and that even though our languages may sometimes seem a bit different from one another, we are glued together by common concepts, such as respect for human dignity, meaningful access, active consultation and involvement, among others. Do you recall how amazing it was when the humanitarian actors spoke the language of the CRPD? Do you recall the sessions DPOs had talking about international humanitarian law like the experts they were? Yeah. Well, I remember. And I remember too that on the third day, we talked about creating safer spaces. And how, by focusing on Article 3 of the CRPD, and how these principles underpin humanitarian principles, that we must consider all the principles of the CRPD in humanitarian action. Do you remember all the CRPD principles? What about the humanitarian principles? Our journey of a thousand miles continues. Do you remember the concepts of equality and non-discrimination? Do you remember the concepts of access, accessibility, reasonable accommodation? Do you remember the exercises we did on how to apply non-discrimination lens through the CRPD? What Article 11 means for humanitarian action? So much we were introduced to, but all linking together, none standing in isolation, all of it building a thread of unity. Sometimes we were invited to interrogate more, to question what we believed in. We had the four corners, and we had those questions that made us question some of our decisions that we make, in all reinforcing that we must all uphold the concepts of autonomy, choice, and supported decision making. We were linking pieces, each session building into another. We were introduced to localization, and we saw how different agencies have different mandates, but all working towards a common goal. And for us, the clear goal remained that, importantly, active consultation and involvement of all was key. And on the fourth day, our journey continued to evolve. We were told about the four A's and Q's. Do you remember them? And that they should be part of our DNA. And we had our hands on some very key tools, asking ourselves if indeed these tools were in compliance with the CRPD and with the humanitarian principles. Reminding ourselves that going forward, that we would have our CRPD eyes and our humanitarian principles eyes in all our engagements, that we may be each other's voice, that going forward, we may fill the missing puzzle, And in there, we will fill it with the CRPD principles, and we will fill it with the humanitarian principles. Our journey of 1,000 miles continues. Thank you.